Greens Creek Mine is the largest silver mine in the last frontier, producing more than 8 million ounces of silver in 2015. But turning these rocks into riches is risky work. Miners at Greens Creek have to chip away at the mountain's foundation, 12 feet at a time, using hundreds of pounds of explosives. But generating a blast isn't as simple as lighting a stick of dynamite. They have to set liquid explosives several feet into the rock in a perfect arch pattern.
The natural arch is inherently a safer geometric form. So in the primary developments in the ore accesses, we want an arch.
Placing the explosive requires precision and one of the mine's mightiest machines, the two-boom jumbo drill.
Double-boom jumbo is like a transformer.
This 23-ton machine can bore 12 feet into the toughest rock using not one, but two hydraulic arms. 45 holes later, the crew has set the explosion pattern. They've placed each hole specifically to create a chain reaction.
So this is our first hole, which is gonna make a hole from this big to that big. And we're just making a little hole into a bigger hole all the way around till we get this big hole that we're standing in.
Now, they're ready for the powder man. The powder man pumps liquid explosive into each of the 45 holes drilled into the rock. He uses a dangerous mixture of fertilizer and diesel.
It's all linked to a centralized blasting system. It's very sensitive, and we certainly don't want any external interference, and we don't want to put anybody at risk for having explosives go off prematurely.
The team has set the explosives and evacuated the tunnel. It's the moment of truth for the miners.
Let's go ahead and confirm.
And with the click of a button, a powerful explosion blasts the ore.
All right, boys, good job.
Okay.
The blast was successful. The explosives broke free 300 tons of rock. It's a potentially prosperous haul.